was a girl with a wicked mind, but everything looks better when the sun goes down. I had everything, opportunities for eternity. Okay, so his contacts are already in. Taylor has some piercing baby blue eyes, as you can obviously see, and this is the makeup reference I'll be going by. So first off, starting off with some moisturizer, which obviously moisturizes my face because it is freshly cleansed. Then going in with my foundation, which is the Maybelline Fit Me In Classic Ivory, and I'm going to be applying this with my XO Beauty Beauty Blender, or Flawless Finish Sponge, either way. So now diving into my concealer, I'm taking the middle top middle shade and the bottom right shade, I think. They're putting this under my eyes to brighten up, as well as my forehead and my chin. And then I'm going to be using my sponge again to blend it all in. Now lightly baking under the eyes to set my concealer in place and prevent it from creasing, even though it creases anyway. And then I'm going to be pretty much setting the rest of my face, but then I'll switch up to my brush anyway. So now diving in with my pomade and my XO Beauty Grimmer brush, I am starting off with some brows, obviously, by doing upward stroke motions. Daisy Perkins does the same thing with her brows from what I last remember with her routine video. So I'm basically doing upward stroke motions, and then because I made it look a bit crooked, I did squint with some concealer and just clean up the bottom half of it. But then I continue to fill it in so it looks a bit more defined and less faded. So just constantly doing upward stroke motions. I did it a little tiny bit here because she has very sparse brows at the very, very front, but the rest of it is quite reasonably very, very fine, like her own hair, but very bushy at the same time. So precisely the same thing on the other side, upward stroke motions, like the way Daisy Perkins does it. So then I was just setting over with powder just to have give it a bit more of a faded look so it looks a bit more realistic. Now I'm going with my Naked Basics and going in with Naked 2 and the brush that came with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Moment Renaissance palette. I completely forgot to use this brush in my first impression, so I'm making up for it now by using the smaller squatier end to contour my nose. So following this, I know it's a bit hard, so I'm doing it at the tip of my nose here, but basically I just add a little V shape at the tip of the nose. I'll just basically follow the same reference of Taylor's nose. We have pretty much the same nose length, it's just hers, she had a bit of contouring done, so I did the same thing, sweeping away the excess background under my eyes. So adding patches of my powder, I forgot what I was using for a second, just to bake the tip of my nose. So now I am priming the surface of my eyes, obviously, with my MAC Paint Plus of Ochre, and then setting over that with some more powder, which is the same powder on my nose. Now going to my Ronin Renaissance palette, I forgot to show you the colour when I'm done filling and balancing and brushing my nose. I forgot to show you the colour, but I am using the orange, I think it was, in my crease as a transition tone to start off with. And now taking this particular colour here, I am nowhere near familiar with the name, so if you know the names then you know what I'm using. But I'm basically doing it in the halo eye, because she has a halo eye in her makeup in the reference picture. So I put it on the inner corner and the outer V, but leaving the middle blank. I'm sort of arching it over the top of my crease, which you see right here. And I'm taking the exact same shade that we just last used, or I last used, under my lash line, because she's not really afraid to have quite a lot of heavy pigment under her eyes. It's like a more cleaned up version of Maria Brink. So dusting away the nose bake, and then taking this particular shade, because it's slightly darker and more like cool tone sort of brown, I'm adding this into the exact same spots, and the outer V, the inner corner, and sort of over the bridge of my crease, as well as my lower lash line. Then I'm taking a little bit of water from Nikki Tutorials and placing this on top because she has got a bit of black shading done into her eyes as well. That's what makes it so dark. Like, it's still very brown, but it has bits of black. So I pretty much put that all on top of everything, except in the middle, leaving the middle blank. Then taking my Sunkissed Palette in this bronzy toned colour, or copper tone more specifically, and obviously using my finger to place this because I feel with the brushes the pigment doesn't pick up as much, so using my finger just to be on the safe side. and just using my brown brush. Okay, using the brush just to blend it out some, then taking, I think it was Burnt Orange again into the crease just to blend it out some, and then one of the browns that I used onto the surface of that golden colour just to sort of help blend it in. To my annoyance, this eyeliner is dried out, so I had to go in with a plastic quality brush from Color Cosmetics and Jeffree Star Black Rainbow to, of course, line my lash line. So also taking this into my waterline as well, or my lower lash line actually, but then going in with my tight line, which is right now underneath the lashes. So I'm adding a little bit more of Wanted to the outer crease area, because hair isn't afraid to have a lot of black there. So I was also adding a bit of the palest nude colour that's in the palette onto the brows, or the brow bone. Now curling up my lashes to Asgard Gods, and then I'm going to go in with my roll lash from Benefit, the mini one. I'll eventually upgrade to the larger one, or the regular size one. Mascaring up my lashes. I'm beginning to trip over my words, bear with me guys. So now taking Jeffree Star's Unicorn Blurb, first lining my lips with Berry Joe K. Then adding on top of that with my black line, which is the first one that I could use, I am adding a little beauty bark, also I might call it a mole either way, adding that onto the left side of my top lip. Then going with this middle shade for contouring, and going to be contouring my cheeks so I can level it up to Taylor's naturally high cheekbones, and sort of taking that onto the sides of my jaw as well, because she has more of a heart-shaped face. I'm sort of drawing it a bit more closer to my mouth than I usually would. Then taking a very, very light amount of champagne truffle onto the higher points of my cheekbones. So I sort of felt like I lost some of the contour, so go back in with the same shade, Naked 2, just to help define my nose a bit more. And then fix spraying, and then that is it. Well, then I added some of my brown shade to my roots to give my bigger, more realistic look. So that is how you can complete this entire look. Thank you all so much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and I shall see you all for my future videos. Oh!